Full Plate. Just like the song says, I'm so glad you're here. My name's Rebecca Rainier, and if you would take a look here, I have been surrounded by babies. It's a baby invasion today on Full Plate. Why? Well, why not? Because they're all adorable, first of all. But second of all, Ashley Glinka here is come up with an idea that solves a problem a lot of moms have when they've got new babies, and actually older babies too. It's the babe that you're trying to carry around, and when do you find the time to exercise, right?
Exactly.
So talk about the problem you were having.
We developed Ballerina Baby after Annabella here was born. I'd always grew up doing music, dancing. I danced with Toledo Ballet. I competed nationally in ballroom dancing. And then I also worked for the Walt Disney World Company.
Mm-hmm.
So music,
what'd you do
dancing,
there? You do like at the park or
I
something?
Worked at the park. So
okay.
I did the college program, and then I did recruiting when I came home on college campuses for them.
Oh, neat. So dancing was always part
dancing
of
dancing music, it's always been a part of my life. It's always been a stress relief for me, something that's relaxing. I had a difficult pregnancy. I was on bed rest for most of it.
Mm-hmm.
And she was born during the snowpocalypse of last year.
So you were trapped.
I was trapped in the house.
I wasn't
getting out. So as a new mom, my husband traveled a lot. And I was trying to find a way that I could get back into shape and do things again with my little one.
Mm-hmm. So you'd go to work out and then what
I'd
would
go
happen?
To work out, and she would wake up inevitably from her nap time. She'd be hungry. She'd be up. Something would be happening. I was a proponent of baby wearing,
okay,
and I wore her around the house a lot. So
which
one day,
you can see, we're all wearing a baby. I am not wearing a baby. I hope to never
we can give
wear
you one
a baby
of the twins.
Again. I'll pass. But this is a way to kind of get through your day with the baby near you.
Exactly.
Comforts the baby.
Baby wearing has a lot of benefits.
Uh-huh.
As a breastfeeding mom, it can help keep that bond. It helps just bond, even if you're formula feeding, bottle feeding. It's a way to soothe them. They'll fall asleep a lot of times just bouncing in the carrier on mom.
Mm-hmm. Do you
and
do your chores in the house
I
wearing
do.
Your baby?
I garden outside, I do laundry, I cook dinner sometimes, pop them up on the back. If you have multiple children like Chloe and Kelly here.
Yeah, let's take a look here. We've got twins.
Yeah.
Baby, one step forward, and so you can see, that's perfect. See, look at two babies. You've got twins, look at that. Okay, now that's a workout, just standing there with two babies.
Exactly.
So you're baby wearing, you're trying to fit in your exercise.
You're trying to fit in your exercise. So I went downstairs with her one day, and I'm lucky I have a dance area downstairs. And I just started doing basic ballet with the music on. And within 5 minutes, my crying baby was asleep.
Oh my gosh.
And she was happy as can be. And it was a way that I then started working out at home, was just doing ballet with her on my own. As the weather warmed up and I got out and started going to mom activities, I was talking to people, and Kelly was one of the first ones that was really interested in what I was doing with the
and
ballet.
And she had the two trying to, oh my gosh. Also, clearly you look like a ballerina, so you had some experience. This was part of your workout life also before the double babies.
So as I got to meet moms in the community, we realized that there was a need for something.
You keep talking and I'll worry about this.
For something that you could bring your little one with you, because so many activities were for the toddlers or older babies, and there was really nothing for the little ones.
That is a microphone. We can't hear mommy if we take it. Don't bite it. Okay, so it sort of developed out
it
of your need.
It sort of developed out of the need. So Harmony and Life in Sylvania is where we teach at.
Okay.
We do classes twice a week.
Okay.
And they usually start with 15 to 20 minutes using chairs. So I make it a workout that moms can do at home. You don't need any special equipment.
Okay. Yeah.
You don't need to have a ballet bar. You don't need to have a dance studio. We do bar work starting off. Just working on the
core. She's just zoned in on the microphone no matter what we do. Look at this. This is so much more interesting. Okay, so you start with the chairs.
We start with the chairs doing 15, 20 minutes at the bar.
Mm-hmm.
And then from there, we progress to the center doing some simple floor exercises.
Okay.
It's a low impact workout. It works on strengthening, toning, stretching. And then depending on the babies that day, how everything's going, we'll spend 5 to 10 minutes on the floor doing mat exercises with yoga, Pilates, working your core again, stretching out, interacting with our little ones, bonding with them. It's a very laid-back class.
We invite
any moms with any babies. Our youngest is about 7 weeks that we've had, and our oldest is a little over 2.
Right, and you've got the oldest baby in our group today. 18 months, you said?
Yep.
Okay, so why don't we see what it kind of looks like? So let's have your moms. How do we do it? What are some of the basic moves for ballet baby moms?
We're gonna start. So do you guys want to come forward a little bit?
Okay, not too far because we got to be able to see you. That's good. That's good. Okay.
We're going to start in first position. So just making that diamond with your feet.
First position.
And our hands can be on our babies, or we'll just bring them up and out. Okay. And to the count of two, we're just going to do two demi-pliés. Mm-hmm. So one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Then we're going to move to second position. And we're going to do the same thing. So just two demi-pliés. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four.
Look at the resistance training when you have twins. Then, it's like the benefit of twins.
You're
going to
make sure that you stay pulled up really tall and keep your belly button towards your spine, keeping that core in tight so you're not leaning forward with the babies.
And that's the thing, how safe, you need to keep the baby safe at all times.
At all times. That's our biggest thing, is just making sure it's comfortable for mom and baby. They're both happy. Mm-hmm. So then in third position, we're going to do two demi-pliés, and then we're going to do two tendus forward. So just pointing that foot. So we're going to go one, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Now we're going to tendu forward. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Passe up. So we're going to have a little balance here. Close it to the back. And then two tendu back. So one, two, three, four.
You have a real tight movement here in your legs.
Four.
Keeping it nice and
exactly.
Frame.
Yep. Okay. Keeping everything
keeping
tight.
Your balance together.
Keeping your balance. And that's the biggest thing, that we're just working through the legs, doing the repetitive exercises. So it gives you a great leg workout. It gives you a great core workout because you're staying tall. You're staying pulled up. You're really engaging your abs.
And what's the baby benefit? Do they seem to be pretty calm for the most part?
They
or do.
Do
they melt? There's no meltdowns? Have you ever had meltdowns?
No.
A little meltdown? Sometimes.
She's a little older. But
she's older. She's getting like, I want my own. I want to do it myself.
That's the thing. If they start getting really fussy, we pop them out of the carriers. We pop them on our hips. Sometimes if they're older, we'll let them stand beside us and just kind of move and do the moves with us. We make it so that every mom and baby is individual. They're treated as an individual in the class.
Well, and you know, I will say one of the most stressful things is to try to go to a workout and, you know, you use the maybe the child care or you try to get it in a certain amount of time, or then you're afraid they're going to freak out at the child. I mean, there's so much stress involved in leaving the baby when you try to work out, that if you can just have them with you, you can maybe have a better and more calm experience.
Exactly. And we're trying to build that community of moms in the classes. So
everyone support each other.
Yeah, everyone understands that if your baby's fussing and you need to sit down and feed them, or you need to pop them out, there's no judgment, because we've all been there.
And all done that.
It's a great way for us to sit there with someone that has an older baby, like Chloe or Kelly, who has an older son, and be like, is this normal?
Is this normal?
This is what she was doing last night. She was up every hour. Is this normal?
So wonderful. So again, say where you have your classes.
So Harmony and Life is where we have our classes. We have a Facebook page, Ballerina Baby. All of our schedules on there. We do giveaways.
Okay. And I'm just I'm guarding this mic.
Holding this mic.
Of course, the main thing she wants is the mic. That's always the way. Thank you guys so much. Everyone did great. Nobody melted down. Everything smells good. I say we go to break. Cut our losses. We're doing good. Thank you guys so much, Ballerina Baby. Good job. Good job. Back in a moment. Y'all did good.